Hello, everybody. So this is my Aunt Dawn. She's my auntie. And my Aunt Dawn just had an incredible deliverance. She got it done. This is her second deliverance that she's gotten. My Aunt Dawn was diagnosed with
the most serious cancer. All her bones, her body, her head.
From head to toe, from toe to head. Cancer everywhere.
Okay. So, she was told that she was going to have a couple of
chemos.
A couple chemos. And that if they didn't see anything that changed, any progress, that they wanted to stop doing her chemo. And that if she would get basically like an in-home hospice or hospice. So, she said, I'm a fighter. I'm not going to quit. I'm not going to give up. And we did a deliverance on her. We did the second one. And ever since the first one, her tumors feel like they are disappearing and shrinking. And being that they're shrinking, they're moving around now because of shrinking. So, with that said, how did you feel after you got your first deliverance?
At peace.
At peace.
And wholesome and courage.
And more energy.
More energy.
And I could dance.
Yeah, she was dancing after the first deliverance. So, we decided we were going to do sessions for her. Just because, you know, she has minor aches and pains.
Because I'm cute.
Because she is cute.
Yeah.
So, you are cute, though. You are cute. She's a sweetheart. So, she is going to go back and get her imaging done. And we're letting the greatest physician of all, Jesus Christ, heal her. And we're praying that they're going to show some type of shrinkage or anything. And if we see that that's happening, which it is, because the person that is delivering her said that the Lord had told him 2 days before I had called him and told him, hey, my auntie wants a deliverance. He ended up telling me that the Lord told him, the deliverance minister, that he had a really huge case that he was going to send his way. Well, this is the case. And not only that, his daughter ended up getting a dream the night before. Was it the night or the day of? The night before the first deliverance, she had a dream. And she had a dream of my Auntie Dawn being, she was inside of a lake in front of their house. And what happened was, the girl, Nicola, was observing everything. And she said that her dad, the deliverance minister, went out and grabbed my auntie from the lake in front of their house. He pulled her out of the water. And she said that she seemed like she thought she was like dead, but she wasn't. She was still alive.
On her last leg.
On her last leg, basically. So he picked her up and took her to the backyard and resuscitated her. That was just a really bigger confirmation that, like, yeah, this is confirmation. They're supposed to be healing her. And she's been doing a lot better. And really, really, really have a lot of people praying for her. And we couldn't be any happier than what the Lord's doing for her. And we plan on doing an update and showing you this is the before and then her after video. So is there anything you want to add?
Just always have courage and believe in the Lord, the Holy Spirit, and our Savior, dear Jesus, forgiving the sins. And the Holy Spirit and Trinity, and best of all, always have courage.
Amen.
Remember the lions in the den. You know, when they opened the big thing, Daniel was sitting, and the lions were laying, and the lions didn't eat Daniel.
Yeah.
And because the Holy Spirit came into the night and said, don't be afraid.
Amen.
Have courage. And courage was there, and the Lord went back to heaven, and he Daniel crossed his legs, and Daniel, the lions laid down. Amen. And when they opened the thing, they looked, and blessed be, he's still alive, and the lions, and
they didn't need him.
Amen to that.
Amen.
So, I have to remind myself, have courage and don't be a quitter.
Faith.
And have faith. But most important, have faith in yourself and have courage and don't be afraid and don't be a quitter.
Amen.
Okay? Being
and
a quitter.
Trust in Jesus.
And trust in Jesus, but don't be a quitter. See, this is what I look like with this. And first, I made me cry. And then I had to wipe my tears away and take another step forward. It's not through strikes, you're out.
Amen.
But see? Courage.
Courage.
I'm growing hair!
So, I love it.
So don't give up.
Amen.
And be proud of yourself.
Lord Jesus
whoever
Christ.
You are. And if you have any problems, give it to the Lord.
Amen. Put it at the Lord's feet.
Now, I have to put this on because I can scare the outside because they don't know who I am or what I am.
John 14:14, Jesus said, if you ask anything in my name, I will do it.
Amen. Amen. And also real quick before we turn this off, how did you rate your deliverance?
More than words can say, and the Fonz would say like this, but my heart says, thank you, dear Lord. Thank you, dear Jesus, Savior of sins. And thank you, dear Holy Spirit. And thank you, dear Trinity. And thank
Amen.
You, dear the man that
Brother
did
Rome.
Brother Rome, did the deliverance twice. And his daughter,
Nicola.
So please, Lord, bless them and guide and guard them in their footsteps. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.
Amen. All right, family, we love you. Keep praying for my Aunt Dawn, and we will, Lord willingly, make a new video when she is completely 100% healed. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Shalom. Bye-bye.
Shalom.